Hi guys, I'm back again. So today we are going to discuss about two immensely popular form of business, namely limited liability partnership and private limited company. So many a times it happens that the entrepreneurs do have the idea and also the resources to form their own business, but they do not know what kind of business structure would suit them the most. And hence, the desired outcome is not achieved. So today, what I'm going to do is I'm going to help you out to understand what business structure would suit your business the most. A private limited company is a privately held business entity where the liability of the members is limited to the number of shares held by them. A limited liability partnership is a business entity where two minimum members are required to start the process, and the liability of the members is limited. If you wish to know more about the respective business structures, why don't you go to our page and have a look at those videos. So now let's understand the similarities between these two business structures. The limited liability partnership and private limited company have a separate legal entity, and they also have a limited liability to its members. They both enjoy the benefits on the taxes given to them. Now, there is no minimum requirement on the share capital for both these business structures, and both of them are required to be registered on the Ministry of Corporate Affairs. So now let's understand the dissimilarities between these two business structures. A private limited company is governed by Companies Act 2013, and limited liability partnership is governed by Limited Liability Partnership Act 2008. The minimum number of members required in a private limited company is 2 and the maximum is 200, while that in an LLP, the minimum number is 2 and there is no limit as far as the maximum number is concerned. The minimum number of directors required in a private limited company is 2 and the maximum number is 15, while that for LLP, the minimum number is 2 designated partners and there is no limit as far as the maximum number is concerned. Now, the compliance requirements of a private limited company is higher than that to a LLP. A private limited company must hold minimum 4 board meetings every year, while there is no such requirement for LLP. In a private limited company, the shares can be easily transferred unless restricted in the articles of association, whereas for an LLP, the shares can be transferred by executing an agreement before a notary public. Now, as far as FDI is concerned, there is a difference in how both these structures can accept investments from foreigners. In a private limited company, FDI is eligible via the automatic and the government route. Now, as far as the name is concerned, the private limited company's name must end with private limited, whereas that for LLP, the name must end with LLP. So now you must be aware about the similarities as well as the dissimilarities for both these business structures. But if you're an entrepreneur who's looking for an external funding and a good turnover to start with, I think private limited company is the best suitable business structure for your business. And if you are more than two people and if you want to start the business with limited liability, then I think a limited liability partnership is the best business structure for you. So I hope I have cleared all the confusion and doubts as far as what kind of business structure would suit your business the most. But if you still have any queries, why don't you leave your contact details in the comment section below, and one of our team member will reach out to you soon. So if you have liked this video, please hit the like button, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel, and also hit the bell icon if you want to get more notifications coming your way. Till then, this is Anuja signing off. Be safe and be compliant.